Have you heard of Icecream? Well, probably not, but because of this article there seems to be a lot of fuss about maybe using Icecream instead of the print statement. Now, this article doesn't say you shouldn't use a print statement, it just suggests that you use Icecream rather than print for debugging. Okay, so let's have a look. What is this Icecream function? So let's do some research. Well, we have the article, and if we go into GitHub, it does talk about Icecream. Now, it's a bit confusing. It says it's 40% faster, but it's 40% faster to type. And then it goes through some examples. So that's the GitHub page. We have the actual article itself a couple of times. We can download the Icecream. Oh, we've got a Reddit comment about the person when they created it. I got tired of printing variables, so I built Icecream, a little library to sweeten debugging. Okay, so may have some uses there. Again, the article. And we've got some, again, some pages talking about maybe some benefits of Icecream. So that's worth having a look at, perhaps, if you want to use it. Now, on YouTube, we can see that people have seen this article and have started making videos. And when I've looked through these, they don't give any information at all. They don't explain why you should use it. They just create the code that's already in the article or the web pages we've already seen. If we go further down, if we look for like the providers of instructions such as Corey Schaefer and Socrita, then we're looking more about like unit testing rather than using Icecream. So perhaps if you're serious about debugging, then perhaps look at unit testing rather than a small function. That's not to say it doesn't have advantages. So let's have a look at Python Icecream. Here we start with importing Icecream using the alias IC. And we've got a function that just adds 5 to a number. And instead of printing it, we're going to call it using IC. So you can see here we've got two examples where we've called the function with 4 and 5. We'll get the output 9 and 10. Now, if we run that, you can see we get more than 9 and 10. We actually print out IC stroke, and then we've got the function name, and we've called it with 4, and then we've got the function name, called it with 5, and the output 9 and 10. So that gives us more information, so that might help us when we're debugging. So that's something different using IC than print. So this could be an advantage when we're debugging. We can actually see more information such as our function name. Now, something else we might need to do is focus on a certain area of code, which normally means commenting out our print statements, for example. But with Icecream, we can use a feature that allows us to disable the code. So we disable it and then enable it for the code we want to check. So that could be a very useful feature. Now, when we run this, we won't run the first function, but you could see there's an error. So perhaps there's more to Icecream than just running it. So we can reopen Spider and run it again and show you that we've called the first function, gives us all the details. The second function. We disabled it through the first function, so that worked. So we had to reopen Spider to get that work, because there was an error message. So we need to understand a bit more about Icecream than we do already. Now, we've taken some code from the internet to check how Icecream works and how efficient it is. Here's some code from the URL you can see at the top. And this compares our print statement, Icecream, and PP from Snoop. And when it finishes, you'll see the times and also how much faster print is than Icecream and faster print is than PP. So Our print statement certainly shouldn't be replaced, it's very important to us. But when we're using other tools, such as debugging tools, we need to understand they may not be as efficient, but they have a purpose. So we need to understand that purpose to use them. So we could look at different figures about how fast and how slower these tools are. But generally, let's stick to using the print statement and then use the tools for what they are used, what they are built for. So here we can see that print is 33 times faster than IC, 8 times faster than PP, which seems to be a bit of an exaggeration. Well, we've wrote some code here that calls a function. The first one, Icecream, quite slow. Printing the function, quite slow. And using the variable, so we return the variable and then print that variable, the final option, which is the fastest method. So that shows us that if you want to return a variable, collect that variable and print it first is a better way. So that shows us Icecream with a function, and again we can see that if we use different methods of comparing the time between print and Icecream, what we're doing is we're using Icecream for something it wasn't built for. So it is slower than print, but it's not built to replace print, it's built for debugging purposes. So don't go out and start using Icecream rather than print just because you've read an article. So what's our verdict? Well, it's not faster than print, but then the author of the article didn't say it was. He said it could be useful for debugging, which it could be if it gives us more detail and has some advantages like being able to disable and enable during your code, so in your testing. So we really need to try it when we're coding, not for loops, but actual long pieces of code during projects. So perhaps we can review it again once we've actually used it over a period of time. So let's withhold judgment now. We're not saying you should use it. We're not saying it's not good. What we're saying is let's understand it and let's try it out and see if it's worth using. And let's come back to this video once we really know something, rather than just repeating the code that's already been given. Well, click that subscribe button if you haven't already, and click that bell as well, because we've got some videos coming up. We've got some interesting videos, more function tools, iter tools, generators, even language processing. They've got some great ideas, some videos coming up. So be notified and don't miss anything.